All right. In this example, I may be doing a more complicated project where we're going to try to make an animated video of the crime that's happening in Madison during one day. So in the end, it should look something like this animation here. I may play it. And each time a crime occurs throughout the day, one of these red dots shows up. Several pieces make this challenging. We need to have the animation piece. We need to be able to draw the map as part of the animation. And you can also see if I pause it that instead of just flashing a dot there for an instant and taking it away, we're going to try to create this slow fade out effect, right? So we're going to have to learn some more advanced techniques for that. And then the other thing that makes this complicated is that the original data set doesn't give us the coordinates of each crime. So we're going to have to do something called a geocoding to figure out where the latitude and longitude are. Given that, it's going to require us to use Google's web API. And so this is really tying together lots of stuff, the maps, the animations, and then the web stuff. So I'm going to break this down into three videos. And the first one, we're just trying to figure out the time of day that each of these things happens. So I'm going to head over to the City of Madison website and go look at the data. And we're going to look at health and public safety. And we're going to look at the police incident reports. And notice that this is not all of them. These are just ones that have significant public interest, right? So I'm doing that because it kind of demonstrates the things that I want to show without having too much data, right? You can imagine a better animation might be all the data over a year, including things that they don't deem to be interesting. Okay, so I'm going to download this data. Right-click on the full data set. I'm going to download it as a spreadsheet. Right-click on that. Copy link address. Let me head over to my terminal. And I'm going to download it here. And I'm going to say wget. Paste that. I'm going to say dash capital O. I'm going to call this crime.csv. And great, I have that. Okay, so in this first part, let's take a peek at that data in a new notebook. So we're going to have three pieces here. Let me create this new Python notebook. And here what I'm going to do is just read it in. So I'm going to import pandas as pd, pd.read.csv, prime.csv, put that in the data frame. Okay, so lots of stuff here, incident IDs, the type of thing, case number, date, address, and some other details. So as I mentioned, right, there's no latitude and longitude. So really, to create this animation, the only things we're interested in are when it happened and where it happened. So right away, I'm just trying to filter this down. I can put a list of columns here, right? So if I create a list like this, I get these double brackets. I want to know the incident date, and I want to know the address. Okay, so a little bit simplified there. And so now, in this part of the video, I'm going to be dealing with this incident date, and then later on, I'm actually going to worry about the address. So let's take a look at the incident date. Of type object. Let me just see what those types are. So if I look at the top, left, right, like this, I can see that I'm ending up with a string there. Right, you can see that by the quotes. So to work with this, I'm going to have to somehow convert that column into something I can actually work with. I want to have some sort of date type. And the way I can do that is with this pandas.toDateTime function, right? So I'm going to use that, and I have to pass in a series, right? So the series I'm going to pass in is that column, right? So incident date. Let me just peek at that. And now I see I have this new date time column, and they're inferring some sort of time zone. They're also kind of making assumptions about what this format means. There's ways to pass in other stuff where you could specify that if you like. There's a format here. But at least for the purpose of this example, they're making a reasonable guess about the format of the data. So I'm just going to roll with that for now. And I want to shove this new series of these date times back into the data frame. So I'm going to do that. Let me just peek at it again. You can see it's a little bit differently formatted now. Right now it's an actual date time type rather than this other thing. Okay, so there's two pieces that I want to do with the dates. One is that I want to pull out the date by itself. What I'm going to do for the next part of the animation, well, a little bit later, is I want to be able to plot all the crimes that happened during a specific day. And then the other thing we're going to have to do is we want to convert this time into a percentage throughout the day, right? So I can say, you know, 50% through the day, that's noon. You might remember when we were doing all the animations earlier, right? I would keep track of what percentage of the way we are through. So to do this, I have to pull those things out. And so let me look at this incident date. Just like when I have strings, right? There's this string accessor, right? If I wanted to convert everything to lowercase, I do something like that. For dates, there's something similar, but instead of str, it's dt for dates. And so I can use that, and if I wanted to, I could pull out all the dates individually. And I'm just going to do that now. So I'm going to say data frame of date equals that. And let me peek at my data frame again. Right, so I have that pulled separately. That's going to make it really easy for me to filter on day. Okay, so that's the one piece. The other thing I want to do is I want to figure out what percentage of the day is through. Okay, so to do that, what I'm going to do is do a little bit of subtraction. What I want to do is I want to take this and I want to round down. So I'm going to say 4. And I could put different things here to say, do I want to round down to like the week or the day? I want to round down to the day. So I'm going to do that. You see, that's a little different than before, right? Before, when I was pulling out the date, I was only getting a date object back. Here, when I'm rounding down, I actually have a date and a time together, but it's very similar, right? Because the time is 0 since I've rounded down. So what's the benefit of this? The benefit is that I can do something like that. And by kind of subtracting the actual date time by just the date itself, I get only a time. Right, so I get just those times. And what I want to do, let me actually just put this in a series for now. I want to take a peek at what type I have here. I see I'm dealing with this time delta. Right, that's what happens when I subtract one time from another. I get a time delta. That's kind of intuitive. And what I want to do is I want to have a percentage of the day that is complete. So what I want to do is I want to divide by a time delta of one day to get a percentage. So I'm going to head up here, I'm going to say from date time import. The main one I need right now is time delta, but just as review, other useful ones are date time. You know, it's a little funny, right? Date time, and then date, right? So we already have these date objects in here. Now I'm going to use this time delta to get a percentage of the day. So let me import those things. And what I'm going to do now, right, is I can divide that one by a time delta of one day. So if I say days equals 1, I get that. I could have just as easily said hours equals 24, same result. But I'll go back to days equals 1. And so right now, what am I doing? I'm dividing just a single value, a single date time, by that. But I can do this as an element-wise operation, right? I can do this on the whole series. Let me just take a peek at that. And why is that not working? It's not working because I need to put parentheses around that. And now I'm getting the percentage of the day that it's through, right? So 0 means it happens just after midnight. 1 means it's happening just before midnight. And so I'm going to put this back as a column inside of my data frame. I'm going to say, what percent was it done? And I'm going to take a peek at this again, like so. Okay, so I've gone from having this incident date, which was originally a string, to this format. I split it up to a date and the percentage of the day that's already through. And that's going to set me up nicely later so I can kind of make an animation of just one day. Before we can do that, though, we're going to have to do this other piece, which is converting the address to latitude and longitude. And I'll be doing that in a separate video.